Good morning, students. So today we'll start with the topic of different components which are used in an electrical power system. So what are the contents to be covered in this chapter are? So namely, first we'll study about cables, classification, or you can also types of cables, insulators, materials which are used for insulators, types of insulators or different types of wires. It may be main types of wire joints, MCBs and features. So these are what the topics which is to be covered in different components which we are using in an electrical power system. So in this lecture, I will be covering the content of general construction of a power cable. So different types of cable and its advantages and disadvantages. So firstly, we'll know about what do we mean by power cable. So a power cable is nothing but it is an assembly of two or more electrical conductors which are usually held together in an overall sheet paper. So the assembly of this cable is used for transmission of electrical power. So mainly power cables are installed either within the buildings or buried under the ground, which are underground cables, or run outside or exposed over the atmospheric condition. Those are nothing but overhead cables. So flexible power cables are also used. They are used for portable devices, mobile tools and machineries. So the general construction of a power cable consists of a conductor or a core wire. It is nothing but aluminium or copper standard wires. Over this, we are providing an insulation, which is paper insulation, and it is a thicker, which provides safety for and also reliability for higher working voltages. Over this insulation paper, we are providing a lead sheet for a power cable. So the lead sheet is being provided in order to fill the gaps, and also it provides or protects the mechanical injuries. Then over the lead sheet, a bedding is been provided. It will be one or two layers of bedding is done, which is done before armoring. So armoring is done in order to protect the mechanical injuries of the power cable. That is nothing but a conductor wire, and it provides or protects the mechanical injuries over the lead sheet and also fills the gaps. So over the armoring, we are providing a serving of a power cable, which is nothing but blackish in color, and it is done over the armoring in order to protect the atmospheric condition. So this, which is in blackish in color, serving of a power cable, it is also having a wash coating so that power cable or the conductor wire can be moved easily inside the serving. So this is what about a general construction of a power cable. So according to this, the classification of power cables has been done. So power types of cables are being classified based on their voltage levels or based on the material which has been used for paper insulations, or it may be also due to manufacturing materials. So we are studying on based on the voltage levels. So according to voltage levels, we have two different types. One is low tension cables, and next is what? High tension power cables. So in low tension power cables, it consists of the inside conductor or a core wire, which is nothing but made up of aluminium or thin copper standard conductors. It is covered with the help of a lead sheet, that is nothing but a paper insulation made up of impregnated paper. So the insulation is being covered with a lead sheet, and lead sheet may be of jute material or it may be fibrous material. So the lead sheet is being covered with the help of a brass or a steel armoring, and then a serving is being done. So this is what low tension power cable, the construction of single core low tension power cables. So the advantage of a single core low tension power cable is they are simple in construction, and availability of this type of power cable is larger. and low tension power cables are used for voltage level up to 1 kilovolt. So next we'll study about high tension power cables. So generally high tension power cables are used for underground cables, which is nothing but a three phase power. So high tension power cables have been classified into three types. One is belted cables, screen cables and pressure cables. So belted cables are used for the voltage level up to 11 kilovolts. So the construction of belted cables is as shown in the figure. So you can see here it consists of three sector shape, which is nothing but a conductor, standard conductors. It is maybe either aluminium or copper conductors. So they are made insulated together with the help of a paper belt. So in order to get a corrective circular shape, it has been filled with a jute filling. So rest all after jute filling, the next is what? The jute filling of the topper, which has been provided with another layer sheet. So in this way, the same construction it remains. Armoring, bedding is been done over this, over that, serving is been done. The construction remains same. Only thing is what? The three core or the standard conductors have been filled with a jute filling and it is done with a paper insulation. So this type of power cables, that is nothing but belted power cables, are used for voltage level up to 11 kilovolt. So next we'll study about screen type of cables. So these cables are used for voltage levels of 22 kilovolt to 33 kilovolt. In this type of power cables, there are again two types, H type cables and SL type cables. So H type of cables was designed by Mr. M. Hochsteller and hence it was named as H type of cable. Here no paper belt is being used in this cable. And the construction of H type cable, it consists of what? Each conductor or each standard aluminium conductors have been covered with a metallic screen and it has been insulated with the impregnated paper. So initially the conductors have been insulated with the impregnated paper insulation. Over this, well, a metallic screen has been insulated so that it can have contacts with each other. So there is an electrical contact between all the three cores. So over this, the next layer will be nothing but a lead sheet and then bedding, armoring and serving. So all the three cores screens, metallic common conducting belt and the lead sheet are electrically in contact and they provide an electrical potential. Therefore, this ensures less electric static stress on the core insulation. So the advantage of this type of screening type of cable is what? It increases heat dissipating power of the cables and there is also a possibility of space elimination. So H type of cables are used for voltage level of up to 22 kilovolts. Next, separate lead screened power cables. So they are also called as SL cables. So in this type of cables, it is similar to H type of cables and the casting is done or the construction of this type of cable is here. The cores, the three cores or the single core is been provided with a separate lead sheet and the insulations have been provided separately. So it is therefore there is no common overall sheet. So the remaining layers are nothing but a bedding, armoring and the serving has been done. Due to the separate lead sheet over the cores, there is possibility of less core breakdown and it can be minimized. So moreover, this type of cables are more flexible and as there will be no common overall lead sheet is been provided. So but this cable type of cable has to be carefully manufactured. So and the SL type of cables are used for voltage levels up to 33 kilovolts. As I have already told you, we have different types of high tension power cable. Firstly, we studied about belted cables. Next, screened cables. Now we'll be studying about pressure cables. So in pressure cables, the voltage levels are beyond 66 kilovolts. So they are also called as super voltage cables. So the above mentioned cables were having solid cables, and they had limitation because of failure of insulation. So in this type of pressure cables, the voids have been eliminated or the spaces have been eliminated by increasing the pressure of the compound, and hence the name has been given as pressure type of cables. So there are two main types of pressure cables. So first is what, oil filled pressure cables, and next we'll study about gas filled pressure cables. In oil filled pressure cables, we can see the oil channel at the center, and the oil channels or the ducts are been provided adjacent to the conductor or the core wire through which oil can be circulated with the help of a pressure, and it consists of a hollow cylindrical steel spiral core which will act as a channel. So over this, the layers of impregnated papers have been done, and then bedding, armoring and serving is been done as compared to other cables. So this type of cables are working on basis that whenever the cables get heated, the due to current passing through it, it will increase the temperature. So through this channel, the volume of the oil can be increased, and hence this oil can be collected in the reservoir. Whenever there is no load or light loads, the temperature can be decreased, and whenever there are high voltages, the or no loads at all, the temperature can be decreased at the reservoirs in the channels or in the channels of the cable. So the advantage of this type of cable is what? It can produce higher dielectric strength, and there will be less possibility of earth fault. Gas type of pressure power cables. So this is nothing but another way of formation of pressure cables. In order to provide the formation or the less presence of voids or in the formation of layers of paper insulation, and it is been provided with the help of a gas pressure, and it is been filled with the nitrogen gas, and it been introduced with the help of a lead sheath and dielectric. So gas such as SF6 is also used in this type of pressure cables. So the nitrogen gas is filled with a pressure of say 12 to 15 atmosphere, and this type of gas pressure power cables are used at a higher voltage beyond 66 kilovolts, as they carry much more current. So the advantage of this type of cable is that it withstand more current or voltages, less maintenance, and also it helps in quenching the flame or the arc provided by the cables. So the main drawback of this type of cable is what? The triangular shape will reduce the weight, and the lead sheet can be acted as a pressure member. So this there was also one more thing, that the sheet is been provided with a thin metallic tip. So this is one of the disadvantage of gas type of pressure cables. So these are nothing but different types of power cables we have studied till now. So if keep watching my videos. If you have any queries, comment in the box. Thank you.